Hey guys, I am Murali. I hope you are all doing well. My intention for this channel is to share my knowledge and also learn from others. So let's collaborate. In the last video, we explored about how PACSIT, that is customer credit transfer, happens in the Fednow clearing. So in this video, let's take another step towards understanding the Fednow service further. I would like to call this as I need more time flow, because this is a decision coming from the creditor agent if they are not sure to process the receipt payment request, which is PACS 008. So they would send PACS 002 ACWP accepted without post. So let's understand it in detail. First step, as usual, the debtor sends the payment request to the bank A where account is held. Bank A performs the required technical and business validation. Once succeeded, Bank A will create PACS 008 message and send it to the Fednow clearing. The Fednow receives the message, and after all the validations, the same PACS 8 is forwarded to the Bank B, which is where beneficiary holds an account. Now the ball is in Bank B's court. They have to respond quickly, and response should reach the Fednow within 5 seconds. So they are forced to take the decision, which might result a fraudulent transaction getting processed. Now remember that Fednow is irrecoverable payment. So once it is credited to the beneficiary, it cannot be forcefully debited back, and return request also not guaranteed. So to avoid this dilemma, if Bank B feels that they would like to take more time to process this payment request under a suspicion that it could be a fraudulent payment or for any other reasons, in that case they can send PACS 002 ACWP. When the Fednow receives this response, then it would immediately recognize this process would take some time or even couple of days in worst case scenario. So they would immediately process with the settlement, because once again remember that ACWP means the request is accepted but only amount is not credited to the beneficiary account. The Fednow sends PACS 002 ACWP response to both the banks. Upon receiving this response, Bank A immediately understands that the payment lifecycle is not completed yet. Bank A would keep this payment request open for closure until they get the final response back. This response can be success or rejection or even blocked. So it is Bank B's responsibility to send the final status to this payment. They can send the following statuses once investigation is completed. ACCC, if the payment request did not have any kind of fault, so they accepted the payment and credited the customer. RJCT, if the payment request did not pass any of Bank B's validation or investigation. BLCK, if the payment request did fail for any of the compliance checks during an investigation. PDNG, if Bank B needs more time for investigation. All of these status are communicated using PACS 002 payment status report via Fednow service. The Fednow service will forward these messages simply to the Bank A. In case if the final status is RJCT, then they will need to send the PACS 4 payment return message. Okay, now this is a question for you all. Why do they have to send the payment return? Please comment your understanding. Okay, let's summarize this concept now. First step, Bank A sends the payment request and it reaches to the Bank B via Fednow clearing. Now Bank B requires some more time for taking a credit decision. At the same time, they don't want to reject this payment request as well. So they send PACS 002 ACWP to the Fednow, and Fednow performs a settlement and informs both Bank A and Bank B. Once Bank B decides on the received payment request, they can send either accepted or rejected or blocked status. They can even send pending status if they require more time. Bank A would keep the payment request open until the final status is received from Bank B. Well, this brings us to the end of this video. I hope you learned something from it. Please leave your thoughts as a comments. I'll read and reply to you. Thank you for watching till the end, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.